What's up everybody, I'm Vegard Heyerdahl, and today we are going to take a look at Warp Stabilizer in Premiere Pro CC 2018. I'm also going to show you how to get rid of that annoying warning message that you get when you work on a HD 4K timeline. So if you are new to the channel, consider subscribing and hit that bell notification icon so you don't miss any future tutorials from my channel. On the timeline here, I have a GoPro clip mounted on a car. And since we're driving in Iceland, it's really bumpy. So to use Warp Stabilizer, you go here to the effects controls. And if you don't see this panel, make sure to be in the editing panel, or you can go to window and down to effects as well. In the effects search box, we search for warp, and in the distort folder, we find this warp stabilizer. So you just simply drag this onto your clip. So it's going to take a little bit of time for the warp stabilizer to do its thing. You can see the progress here in the effect controls window. So when warp stabilizer are done doing its thing, you can check out the quality and the result, and it looks pretty good actually. So that was well. But what about if you work on a HD timeline and you also have a 4K clip? If you just apply the warp stabilizer to this clip, for example, this is a 4K clip, it will give you a warning message. Warp stabilizer requires clip dimensions to match sequence. And it's all red and all over the clip. And to fix this, you just take away the warp stabilizer, just delete that. And you will first want to go to the scale of your clip. Right now it's 100%. So on a HD timeline, it's going to be the double. So if we just write in 50% right here, and then click on this video clip right here and select nest, and you just click OK right there, and now we have this 4K clip in a nested sequence, and that will allow us to use the warp stabilizer on this clip as well. So it's real simple, just use warp stabilizer, put it on the clip, and wait for its thing to complete. So we're just going to skip to the end right here. So when warp stabilizer is finally done analyzing this clip, we get a more smooth clip here of this beautiful church. Keep in mind that every time you use warp stabilizer, it's going to crop a little bit into your footage to make it more stable. So if you have something like a subject or something in the frame that you need to have there, you really need to think about that when you are shooting, and you think about using warp stabilizer in your edits. So I hope you learned something new today. If you want to learn more about Premiere Pro and other filmmaking tutorials, make sure to subscribe and hit that bell so you don't miss any future videos from me. And as always, thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video.